Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video count function in Excel, watch the video till the end. And if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon given below. Welcome everyone. Today we have a topic with us. It's called the statistical function in Excel. Let's begin to understand this topic in a much more detailed fashion. Before we begin, we would like to understand first this topic, what exactly it is all about. See, the count function in Excel is basically a statistical function which is used to count the number of the cells containing the number within the given range, and the count in Excel returns an integer. Okay, it returns to an value in integer number. Okay, so how does the formula starts? You say is equal to count the value 1, value 2. So the count formula in Excel has two arguments, out of which one is required. So the value number 1, it is the required parameter. So that represents the starting date, and the date must be entered using the date function, showing is equal to date function. Then there is a value n, so it is an optional parameter. If you just start with the count function, value 1, value 2, the value 2 is an optional parameter which can range up to 255 values. So the value can be cell references or a range of the values, that is, you know, collection of worksheet cells containing a variety of data, and out of which only the cells containing the number would be counted. So the return value of the count formula in Excel is a positive number, and the value can be zero or non-zero. How to use the count function in Excel? How to use it? So this is basically a worksheet function, and as a worksheet function, count in Excel can be entered as a part of the formula in a cell of a worksheet. We will try and learn here example number 1, count numbers, so as to get a much more integrated idea regarding this topic. Now over here there are different numbers of the sales, and other details are given with the dates in a different format. We will start with C, as shown about over here, the count formula. The count function is applied on the range of B3 to B8. And the range contains only 3 numbers, and hence the result returned by the count function is 3. And the same is displayed in the resulting cell, that is B10. You can refer here. And this are the numbers. Now, the numbers, you can simply, what you can do, enter the formula is equal to count. The value is going to be from B3 to B8. You'll get answer as. Now, as shown in the above count function, the count function is applied on the range B3 to B8. And the range contains only 3 numbers, and hence the result returned by the count function is 3. And the same is displayed in resulting cell, that is in the B10 cell. Now, example number 2. Now, number in the double quotes. How does that exactly works? Okay. So, as shown here, you know, we'll use a count A function. There's a count A function here. And we will say in terms of the value 1, close, comma 2. So again, this will be in the inverted comma, close the bracket, you will get answer as 2. So the values are 1 and 2, and count A function is used capable of processing such values, and hence the result returned and contained by the result cell B11 as 2. And we'll get with one more example here, saying that is equal to count C3 to C8. It will say as 2. Right now, the count function is applied to the range of C3 to C8 here, and the range contains the date representing using the different formats, out of which only 2 are returned in the valid format, and hence the result returned by the count function is 2, and the same is the result of the cell, that is C10. Right. Now, we'll take one more example here. saying is equal to count and select the whole thing C3 to C7, not the full thing, comma 5, close the bracket. You'll get an answer as 3. See, here the count function is applied on the range of the value from C3 to, you can take C8 also, still you will get 3. And another parameter is hard-coded with 5 here. So the result return in the total number of the valid number present in the range, and the number is 5. Now, the example number 5 is going to be a 0 valid numbers. Now, what is this? Let me calculate first for you. We'll use count function again, saying the value from B6 to B8. So now here, the count function is applied on the range of the value from C6 to C8. In the screenshot over here, if you see, in the Excel spreadsheet here, the range does not have any valid number. And so the result returned by the count function in Excel is 0. And the results cell B12, hence it contains a 0 value. Now, what about the empty range? Okay, let me calculate here as count. We'll take here, let's say D3 to D5. It will say a 0. So the count function is applied to the range of the value from D3 to D5. And the range does not have any numbers in the empty cell. So the result returned by the count function is 0. And the result cell D10, it contains a number as 0. Now, there are some of the things that you should remember about the count function in Excel. See, the date values containing the number, dates, or a text, representation of the number, and a number is enclosed in the quotation mark as, and they are counted. Second, the logical values and the text representation. The logical values and the text representation of the number that you type directly into the list of the parameter are also counted. Any error values, any sort of error values of the text function, which cannot be converted into number, is not counted in the Excel count formula. So if the argument in the array is, let's say, or the reference are counted in the Excel count formula, empty cells or logical values, then text or errors value of the array references are not at all counted. Fifth, any further extension to this function is, you can say count a function, and which is to count logical values, text or error values. And another extent is the count if function, which is to count the number of the number that meets a specified criteria. So if you have learned watching this video, if you have enjoyed watching this video, then don't forget, then please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone.